What do you know about Miss McCall, the Lady of the Lintels?
She's an angel. One of the best.
Is her full-time function?
No. She works the time you trot us to. Well, no just dishing up the chuck either, by the way. Wee bit of singing thrown in. Voice like a blackbird.
A blackbird? The blackbird was the Maltese falcon.
Thanks, bud. That's all I needed to know.
Thanks. Riley. It's you, Doghouse Riley. I hardly ever smoke. I've almost forgotten how.
You get used to it. It's easy, like whistling. You just put your lips together and blow.
You do a good job here, honey.
Could have been good, until McCurdy put a stop to it. He's bought the place. He's going to demolish it and turn it into a fast food hall.
Doesn't anybody go to church anymore? Who is he, this McCurdy?
A wide boy.
Do you mean fat?
I mean wide. Wider than the Firth of Clyde and a lot more dangerous. Owner of Tommy Trotter's bar and chairman of the Big Bird Fast Food Company.
The Big Bird Company?
The fat man had reckoned he could take chances with me in the cookie can. Who else could catch his sick little joke?
Yeah.
Where's he based, this McCurdy?
He lives in Giffnock, but his depot's in Partick. Not too far.
Seem to know a lot about this guy.
I had to plead with him to keep this place open for Christmas.
How could any guy be mean to a dame like this?
Would you like to mark my card with the Big Bird Depot? You won't regret this.
Thanks for coming back in again today, Dr. Branch. Just a few more questions I'd like to ask. And the first I can't ask often enough. Just how devious is Clooney?
Well, it depends. He may already have begun to fabricate an entire case, building it up as he goes along. If he's acting like Bogart, he'll rationalize every problem to make it fit.
I don't follow.
Well, if his clothes are too small, he'll say something like, they shrank when he fell overboard from the African Queen. Each new clue will be twisted and frozen into the fabric of his delusion.
But that's crazy.
Sergeant, what do you think he was doing in Spinbini? Unless you find him soon, I'm afraid he could wreak havoc on the streets of Glasgow.
I was afraid you were going to say that.
You look like a man who needs cheering up, Sergeant.
Correct, Doctor. You doing anything Wednesday night?
That's a very good one, sir. No, but seriously, you've got a right smatter here and at a very good price. Come on.
Okay, Big Mouth. You sold me.
Harry! Harry, is that van not washed yet? Mr. Rezid will be here any minute to collect it.
Away, Mr. Wilson.
Just step into the office with me, please, gentlemen.
I'm looking for Harry.
That's me.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to pick up Mr. Azed's van. Mr. Wilson said it was okay.
I've still to wipe it off.
No, it's beautiful finish. Beautiful.
So I liberated a vehicle, but there was no way I could roll up to McCurdy's depot without packing artillery. The friendly neighborhood gun store was McCorkendale's. Everything I needed was inside. As I drove the night streets, I took inventory. If McCurdy was the fat man, I was ready for him. First thing I see is the reception committee McCurdy had organized. Just a couple of goons, sure, but with bulges in their coats. I reckon McCorkendale had the answer to that one. One step at a time, Bogey, and don't show your hand. Sure, they're guarding something more important than turkeys, but why blast them when you could sweet-talk your way in? I started to rummage around in my brain for a game plan. And I found it. All I needed was a little Christmas spirit.
Jingle bells, I jingle Bobby. Yeah. Compliments to the season, boys.
Keep your eye on the big alky, will you, Doogie?
Right, big guy. There's no party here. On your bike.
Oh, that's not very seasonal, is it? Use your lavy.
Look, I don't trust that big bampot. Go and sort him out. I'll get my thanks for the car.
What a pair of clowns. Someone should tell him it ain't enough just to be heavy. Whatever he was paying this guy, it was too much.
See you! You've heard up to you! This is loudy time!
This guy talks so much, he has to be slow on the uptake.
Right, that's his hand!
One last chance, and then the gloves are off.
You didn't need to wreck the place to get out of the big balloon.
Balloon down. Give me the keys to the van.
Oh, no, McCurdy will kill me.
You want to find out what happens to turkeys at Christmas? Good boy. Where do you want it?
Oh, I know the face.
Oh, ow!
Wow. More turkeys than the British film industry. So many guns around town and so few brains. The old bird would be asleep by now, but it was the big bird that interested me, and all those little birds. I was feeling pretty pleased with myself, what with my soft shoe shuffle entrance and the long-awaited promise of things to come.
I see you've acquired some Christmas turkey. You're just in time for a wee cup of Horlicks.
What harm could a quart of Horlicks do? No frail old dame could talk me into spilling all I knew. If I told her anything, it would be because I decided to speak. Me and nobody else.
Mrs. Ann, these ain't no ordinary turkeys. They're not what they seem. On the outside, the skin is cold and clammy, but you and I can only dream of the riches stashed within.
Would you like me to get a hacksaw? I've just been using it on Kitty.
Yeah. I couldn't work it out at first, you see, Mrs. N. I thought, why use a couple of guys with rods to protect a bunch of frozen turkey stiffs? There had to be more to it than met the eye. And then I found something very interesting in the back of the van. Mm-hmm. Ring a bell, huh?
I used to have one in the window. Hell of a difficult to get off.
Mr. Happy, the happy guy, huh? Ah, suddenly it all made sense. Mr. Happy, alias the Fat Man, huh? Glasgow's miles better. Miles better. An obvious, if carefully disguised, mention of Miles Archer, my partner who was murdered in our quest for the Maltese Falcon.
Would you be taking sugar in your Horlicks?
Sir, just one, Mrs. N. Miles better to Miles Archer. The Fat Man was always very fond of wordplay. The arrogant swine. That was him letting the underworld know he was here in Glasgow in this one-horse borough. His little joke. What a sick and twisted mind. White meat, bone,